Good day, mga Nakshi. So, I'm Miss Aika, your math tutor. Our lesson for today is about the addition and subtraction of rational algebraic expression. So, first, we are going to discuss addition and subtraction of rational expression of or rational algebraic expression with the same denominator. For example, we have 6x over 2x plus 3 plus 9 over 2x plus 3. So, as you can see, the denominators are just the same or pareho lang. So, kapag ganito yung case natin that the denominator are both the same, you are just going to add the numerator and then you will just copy the denominator. So, we have 6x plus 9. It will be written as 6x plus 9 kasi hindi natin siya pwedeng i-combine or pagsamahin dahil si 6 ay may kasamang variable na x pero si 9 ay coefficient lamang. Then, you are just going to copy the denominator. So, kung mapapansin nyo, 6x and 9 are both divisible by 3, meaning we are going to factor out 3. If we factor out 3, we have 3. Or, ilabas natin si 3. So, 6x divide 3, that is 2x. Then, positive 9 divide 3, that is positive 3. So, we are going to get 3 multiplied by the quantity 2x plus 3. Then, copy the denominator, 2x plus 3. So, kung mapapansin nyo, meron tayong nakuhang factors na magkapareho sa numerator at sa denominator. So, we can cancel them. Because 2x plus 3 divide 2x plus 3, the answer is 1. So, simply, the simplified form of this rational algebraic expression is 3. So, we have 6x over 2x plus 3 plus 9 over 2x plus 3, the answer is simply 3. Okay, so for another example, we have the subtraction of rational algebraic expression. So, here's our given. We have 9y squared over y minus 2 minus y squared plus 16y over y minus 2. So, as you can see, the denominators are the same. So, you are just going to subtract the numerator or their numerators. Then, you will just copy the denominator. So, we have here 9y squared minus y squared minus 16y all over y minus 2. So, bakit siya naging negative y squared and negative 16y? So, as you can see, ang subtrahend natin dito is y squared plus 16y. At dahil siya po ay subtraction, you are going to distribute the negative sign because we are going to get the opposite sign of the subtrahend. So, kung siya ay positive, siya ay magiging negative. If the given is negative, therefore, it will become positive. Kaya siya naging 9y squared minus y squared minus 16y. Now, combine like terms. Meron ba tayong like terms? Yes, meron. And that is 9y squared and y squared. So, you are going to get its difference. So, 9 minus 1, that is 8. Then, we have y squared. Copy negative 16y over y minus 2. So, as you can see, the numerator has factors. So, you are going to factor out 8 because they are both divisible by 8. So, if you factor out 8, it will become like this. 8y squared divide 8, the answer is y squared. 16y, okay, so, correction. Dahil meron silang parehong variable which is y, pwede rin natin i-factor out yung y. Therefore, ang ipa-factor out natin is 8y. So, 8y squared divided by 8y, that is y. Very good. Then, negative 16y divided by 8y, the answer is negative 2. Very good. Over y minus 2. So, as you can see, pareho yung factors natin sa numerator and sa denominator. And that is y minus 2. y minus 2 divided by y minus 2, that is 1. Kaya, pwede na po natin siyang i-cancel. Therefore, the simplified form of our expression is 8y. So, this is the difference of our rational algebraic expression. So, after the addition and subtraction of rational algebraic expression with like denominator or with the same denominator, we are now going to add and subtract rational algebraic expression with unlike denominator. So, meaning, magkaiba naman yung ating given denominator. For example, we have xy plus y over x. So, as you can see, the denominators are different. First, we have y, and the second one, we have x. So, we are going to get its LCD. So, dahil pareho naman silang prime variables, or it cannot be factor, we can just multiply the two. So, y times x or x times y, therefore, our LCD will become xy. Then, we can add now the expressions. So, xy is our denominator. Xy divided by y. So, makakancel dyan yung y. Anong matitira? Si x. So, x will be multiplied by x, that the answer will become x squared. Then, next one, we have xy divided by x. So, x divide x, that is 1. Then, ang matitira is y. Therefore, y multiply by y, that will become y squared. So, that is positive y squared. Therefore, your final answer here is x squared plus y squared all over xy. So, dito natin i-apply yung natutunan natin sa pagkuha ng least common denominator ng rational algebraic expression. Kaya dapat master din natin yung pagkuha ng LCD para mas madali nating ma-add and ma-subtract yung mga rational algebraic expressions natin. Okay, another example, we have 5 over a cubed b plus 7 over a b squared. So, kung mapapansin nyo, wala siyang kasamang coefficient. Variables lang and the exponent. So, dun, balikan nyo yung lesson natin about LCD. Sa pagkuha ng LCD ng variables, you are just going to get the variable with the highest exponent. So, alin ba dyan yung may highest exponent? So, ang may highest exponent natin for variable A is a cube. And ang may highest exponent natin for variable B is b squared. Therefore, ang magiging LCD ng ating expression is a cube b squared. Now, we can simplify or do the operation. A cube b squared divided by a cube b. So, as you can see, dahil pareho silang may exponent na 3, that will become 1. So, a cube divide a cube, that is 1. Then, ang may iwan is b squared divide b. So, balikan naman natin yung law of exponents sa quotient rule. So, ima-minus nyo yung kanyang exponent. So, we have b squared over b. The answer will become b. Multiply by its numerator, 5. Then, copy the operation, plus. Then, doon naman tayo sa pangalawa. So, we have a cubed b squared. So, a cubed divided by a, that is a squared. And b squared divided by b squared, that is 1. So, we are going to multiply it by our numerator, which is 7. Now, we can simplify this. So, b times 5, that is 5b, plus a squared times 7, that is 7a squared, all over a cubed b squared. Therefore, this is the sum of our given rational algebraic expression. Another example. Okay, another example, we have 5 over 6a squared b minus 3 over ab squared. So, first we are going to get their LCD. So, look at their coefficient. So, kung mapapansin nyo, sa first given rational algebraic expression, the coefficient of the denominator is 6. Dun naman sa pangalawa, the coefficient is 1. Therefore, dahil mas higher yung ating nasa first fraction, yun yung gagamitin natin as LCD. So, we have there 6. Yun ay kung ang kasama niyang coefficient sa another fraction is 1. So, sa variable naman, or pagdating naman sa variable, you are just going to get the highest value of the exponent. So, kukunin natin yung variable na mayroong mataas na exponent. So, here we have a squared and b squared. Therefore, our LCD or the least common denominator is 6a squared b squared. So, let's simplify. 6a squared b squared divided by 6a squared b. So, 6 divide 6, that is 1. A squared divide a squared, that is 1. So, ang may iwan is b squared divide b. So, b squared divide b, that is b multiplied by the numerator, 5. Then, copy the operation, minus 6a squared b squared divided by ab squared. So, 6 divided by 1 as the coefficient of the second fraction, that is 6. A squared divided by A, so law of exponent, quotient rule, the answer is A. B squared divided by B squared, that is 1. So, multiply by the numerator, so we have 3. So, let's simplify our answer. B times 5, the answer is 5B. Minus 6A times 3, the answer is 18A. Very good. Then, copy the denominator, 6A squared, B squared. Therefore, the difference of our rational algebraic expression is 5B minus 18A over 6A squared, B squared. Okay, so for another example, we have here 3 over x plus 1 plus 4 over x plus 2. So, as you can see, both of the denominators are not factorable. So, meaning, you can just multiply the two denominators. So, the LCD for that, we have x plus 1 multiplied by the quantity x plus 2. So, that will be our LCD or the least common denominator. So, LCD divided by the denominator multiplied by the numerator to get our new numerator. So, LCD divided by x plus 1. So, dahil parehong may x plus 1, so we will cancel it out. Ang matitira sa kanya is x plus 2. So, x plus 2 multiplied by the numerator, which is 3. Then, copy our operation or our sign. We have plus, so or positive. Then, LCD divided by the denominator, we have there x plus 1. Basta't may makita kayong same factors naman dun sa LCD, you can cancel it out. Then, kung ano yung maiwan, yun yung imumultiply natin sa numerator. So, we have x plus 1 multiplied by the numerator, which is 4. Then, simplify our answer. So, para ma-simplify yung first numerator na nakuha natin, you are going to distribute it inside the parentheses. So, we have 3 times x, that is 3x. 3 times 2, that is positive 6. So, ganun din yung gagawin natin sa kabila. So, we have 4 times x, that is 4x. And 4 times 1, that is positive 4. Then, copy the denominator. X plus 1 over x plus 2. Then, look at our new numerator kung meron tayo pwedeng i-combine. So, pwede natin pagsamahin yung parehong may variable na x, which are 3x and 4x. At pwede natin i-combine yung parehong coefficient, which is 6 and 4. So, 3x plus 4x, that will become 7x. 6 plus 4, that will become positive 10. And then, copy our denominator, x plus 1 over x plus 2. So, pwede pa natin i-simplify yung denominator by doing the FOIL method. So, meaning, imumultiply natin yung dalawang quantities ng ating LCD. At ang kalalabasan niya is x squared plus 3x plus 2. So, yan na yung bago natin denominator, then copy our numerator. Therefore, the sum of our given rational algebraic expression is 7x plus 10 over x squared plus 3x plus 2. Okay, another example, we have x squared plus 4x over x squared minus 4 minus 1 over x plus 2. So, as you can see, yung isa sa denominator natin ay factorable with the use of the difference of two squares. So, para makuha natin yung ating LCD or this common denominator, we are going to factor first our denominators. So, we have x squared minus 4 and x plus 2. So, the factors for x squared minus 4 using the difference of 2 square, it will become x plus 2 multiplied by the quantity x minus 2. At dahil prime na at hindi na factorable si x plus 2, we will write it as x plus 2. So, dahil may parehong factors tayo, you will write it as 1. So, we have x plus 2 and x minus 2. So, that will become our new least common denominator or our LCD. Then, we are going to divide the LCD by our denominators. So, x plus 2 multiplied by x minus 2, that is also x squared minus 4. So, if the LCD will be divided into this denominator, the answer will become 1. Dahil, pareho lang na may x plus 2 at x minus 2, yung ating denominator na x squared minus 4. So, that is 1 multiplied by x squared plus 4x. So, ito pong nasa quantity na ito ay yung ating numerator or yung ating numerator. Then, we are going to get or simplify the second one. So, LCD divided by x plus 2. So, makakancel si x plus 2, matitira si x minus 2. So, we have minus the quantity x minus 2. So, pwedeng hindi na isulat si 1 because any number that is multiplied by 1, the answer will stay the same. So, pwede rin naman siyang isulat, which will be multiplied by 1. So, let's simplify our answer. So, we have x squared plus 4x minus, pag may multiply si 1, we have x minus 2. Copy the denominator, x plus 2, x minus 2. So, ilalagay natin sa parenthesis yung subtrahen. Bakit? Para ma-distribute natin yung sign which is negative. So, lagi nyong tatandaan na kapag sa subtrahen, magbabago tayo lagi ng sign. Yung mga positive sign magiging negative and yung mga negative sign magiging positive. So, it will become like this. X squared plus 4x minus positive x, that will become negative x, minus negative 2, that will become positive 2, all over x plus 2 and x minus 2. Then, you are going to combine like terms. So, ano ba yung mga like terms natin? We have 4x and negative x. So, it will become, okay, so, sobrahin lang natin yung mga, i-rewrite lang natin siya. Okay, i-rewrite muna natin to. So, we have x squared plus 4x minus x plus 2 all over x plus 2 multiplied by the quantity x minus 2. So, kung hindi nyo nakuha yung solutions kanina, pwede nyo muna siyang i-post para makopya nyo yung complete solution natin. So, i-rewrite lang natin kasi medyo maliit yung board, hindi kakasya yung iba pang solution. So, combine like terms. Ang like terms lang natin is positive 4x and negative x. So, we have x squared, positive 4x minus x, that is 4 minus 1. So, we have positive 3x plus 2 all over x plus 2 and x minus 2. So, if you get the factor of our numerator using the general trinomials, we are going to get x plus 2 and x plus 1. So, yan yung magiging factors natin. Then, copy lang ulit natin si denominator. So, kapag mayroong parehong factors ang numerator at denominator, we can cancel it out kasi ang magiging sagot niya is 1. So, kung ano yung may iwan or yung matitira, that will be your simplified form or that will be your final answer. So, we have there x plus 1 over x minus 2. So, this is our difference. Okay, so ganun lang kadali yung pag-a-add at pag-subtract ng rational algebraic expression, lalong-lalo na yung merong parehong denominator. Pero once na meron na ang kanilang denominator ay magkaiba, huwag na huwag kalimutan na kunin muna yung LCD. Then, kapag nakuha yung LCD, divide it by the denominators of the given rational algebraic expression. Then, multiply it by the numerator. Then, simplify your answer. So, yun lang. Then, sa mga susunod na lesson, so, asahan nyo ulit ako. Aasahan ko rin kayo na panoorin yung mga susunod pa nating videos. So, dapat, master din natin kung paano mag-simplify ng rational algebraic expression at kung paano kumuha ng LCD nito para mas madali na nating masagutan yung mga operations ng rational algebraic expression. So, that is all for today. Goodbye!